When it comes to the Breath of the Wild 2 trailer, I said this before and I said it again, Nintendo really didn't have to go in that hard with that trailer. It was amazing, it was on the edge of our seats, so mysterious, so dark. And the biggest thing that we can take away, other than the green glowing hand deal, is obviously the corpse of what we believe to be is Ganondorf, the fallen great king of evil. And the Zelda community could not be more excited for the return of the king. But with Ganondorf back, we really need to think about his role in Breath of the Wild 2. As in previous Zelda games that featured Ganondorf and an extension, Ganon, it becomes quite clear, by the end of the game at least, that Ganon, or I should say Ganondorf, is the true source of everything, all of the problems that deal with Hyrule. Of course, Demise is the true source of Ganon and Ganondorf, but that's before the time of Hyrule. So in thinking about that, here's a pretty wild video considering that this Ganondorf, is the true source of everything. And I mean everything that deals with Breath of the Wild, the sequel, and what came before the game. What's up, guys? It's HMK once again with another Zelda video. Today, we're gonna focus on our boy Ganny and everything leading up to his return. It's gonna be wild. Breath of the Wild. So for the safety of hype, I'm gonna ask you to strap on in, let's dive directly into the noise. Now like I said before, Ganondorf returning in Breath of the Wild 2 is a gigantic deal, but when it comes to the lore of the overall Zelda series, we know he to be the source of all of Hyrule's problems. While it did all technically start with Demise, this Demon King acted as the primordial catalyst to everything leading up to now when it comes to all of the Zelda games. And while the first Zelda game, way back when, introduced the main villain as Ganon, now we know, thanks to the advents of Ocarina of Time and notes from A Link to the Past, that Ganondorf predated the entity known as Ganon, a human Gerudo that acted as the true reincarnation of Demise's hatred and thereby being the source of Ganon. And when it comes to being the source, this holds true when you look at the Breath of the Wild 2 trailer, with Ganondorf's corpse being locked deep below somewhere, but with malice leaking out. I mean, if I was a betting man, look at that. That looks pretty much like a source to something, if you ask me. The source of malice. And thereby, in extension, this corpse, Ganondorf's corpse, is the source of Calamity Ganon. We've theorized on this aspect before, but I wanted to take it to a new extension, a new level. As we know that Ganondorf, as a human, is incredibly intelligent and a brilliant strategist. We've seen it time and time again in the Zelda games, and I want to assume that even in this state, he may have helped set up the events for his eventual return, but over an extreme amount of time. As in the events that predate Breath of the Wild, both 110,000 years prior, the land was ravaged by Calamity Ganon. Though in the war 10,000 years before the events of Breath of the Wild, when they had the Divine Beasts, the Guardians, the Princess, and the Hero, everything pretty much worked out and they were able to seal Calamity Ganon deep below Hyrule Castle. But this specific situation, this war, this event, along with that happened before Breath of the Wild, has me in a quandary. Because although they're fighting against the Calamity Ganon and the Malice, the entity, the person known as Ganondorf, is known in their history, their legends. Like, there are legitimate records of his existence across different tribes and cultures. If this physical human entity that is known to predate that of Ganon and to be the source, why not look for this specific existence? Almost makes me think as if someone is trying to cover up a lingering existence of Ganondorf, or to make sure that the records passed on into something of legend. You know, kind of like a Legend of Zelda. Okay, I'll stop. Especially since the fact that both times that Calamity Ganon has attacked Hyrule, this entity rose from beneath Hyrule Castle. You would think that after the first time they were able to successfully seal Calamity Ganon below Hyrule Castle, they would go looking under that specific area. Which really makes me believe that this corpse of Ganondorf exists somewhere deep below that of Hyrule Castle. As one, the Calamity Ganon always seems to rise from that specific spot, and two, at the end of the Breath of the Wild 2 trailer, when Ganondorf wakes up, Hyrule Castle rises from the ground. What's more is that I'm pretty sure that the generation of the royal family that dealt with Calamity Ganon 10,000 years ago knew something of that. And that the generation of the royal family in Hyrule that tried to deal with Calamity Ganon 100 years before that of Breath of the Wild even got a hint but took it the wrong way. For those who remember, there was a mysterious fortune teller spoken of in the backstory of Breath of the Wild, one who foresaw the return of Calamity Ganon and warned the king of Hyrule. This is the quoted warning. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. Now, as we all know, this led to the Kingdom of Hyrule excavating huge parts of land in order to find what this fortune teller was talking about. That's when they stumbled upon the Divine Beast and a load of Guardians. And referring back to records they were able to find through the Sheikah, they were like, hey, this is probably what they were talking about. Our ancestors used them, so it should be a piece of cake if we were to rinse and repeat. But as we all know, Ganon is smart and was not having that. But what if this wasn't what the fortune teller meant when there was a power to oppose Calamity Ganon lying dormant beneath the ground? Because you know what else seems to be a power that would oppose Calamity Ganon that seems to be lying dormant beneath the ground? You're probably thinking of it too. That's right, the mysterious, mystical, magical arm that is keeping Calamity Ganondorf at bay. While the malice seems to be still leaking out of Ganondorf's corpse, this power is literally opposing Ganondorf. This is the power that the fortune teller was talking about. Yet, they didn't want to look around deep under Hyrule Castle. Nope. Once again, it seems like they were hiding something. Now, here's when we get into the big brain hour. Literally, Ganondorf's big brain hour. Thanks to the events of Ocarina of Time, Wind Waker, and Twilight Princess, we know that Ganondorf is known for ingeniously putting together events that would proc other people in order to walk a certain path that would benefit him in the long run. Successfully manipulating events and people that would get him to secure his endgame. And with the case of Breath of the Wild and Breath of the Wild 2 and what happened before the games, I feel it's no different. As think about it for a second, Ganon and Ganondorf have never been in an ethereal state like this as we see Calamity Ganon. He's always been something physical, tangible, as although he is intelligent, cultured, carrying a civilized and refined demeanor, he is indeed narcissistic and an egomaniac, and loves to show off his strength and power firsthand in order to establish his dominance. However, Calamity Ganon, all things considered, is definitely an offshoot, something that he's done before with the likes of Aghanim and Xant. What I'm saying is that both strikes of Calamity Ganon were not the plan, but only parts of the plan. Imagine this. We have to consider that Calamity Ganon as this form, as this menace, has struck at least once before the war 10,000 years ago. As a legend like that would have to force the Hylians and the Sheikah to work together in creating the Divine Beasts and the Guardians in order to prepare. What if something like that was part of Ganondorf's plan in order for people to create soulless machines that at one point he would be able to take over with malice, but he had to bide his time. He had to be extremely patient in order to see this to fruition. With the calamity over from 10,000 years prior, we understood that the legends after that would lead into a dissension between the Hylians and the Sheikah that would eventually give birth to that of the Yiga and would lead the technology brought on by the Sheikah, including that of the Divine Beasts and the Guardians, to be lost to time and the earth, effectively regressing a kingdom that was known for its high technological prowess into that of a medieval state, a state of weakening. What if these events were all just a huge domino effect that Ganondorf, from his prison below the ground, was successfully puppeteering thanks to the use of malice and his calamities? And what if somehow he is the source of the word of mouth that spread among the Hylians that led to the king to banishing the Sheikah and forcing them to abandon their technology that effectively led to the creation of the Yiga, who would in turn swear allegiance to and worship Calamity Ganon, and in extension, Ganondorf. And that with these combined events would lead to Hyrule in a tremendously weakened medieval state, that all he needed to do in order to get it primed and ready for his true return was another calamity, in which Hyrule was at its weakest, the Yiga already existed, the Guardians and Divine Beast were there ready to be taken over, which led to Hyrule as a land and a kingdom to be destroyed utterly and completely. And while Link and Zelda and the spirits of the fallen Guardians were able to defeat that Calamity Ganon, the damage had already been done. Hyrule Castle is in shambles. The royal family is all but extinguished, save for Zelda. Their central governing force is non-existent. Their army is dust. Their tribes are scattered. The Sheikah are splintered. Hyrule is truly in one of the worst, weakest states that has ever been in the Zelda series, to the point that they're in the middle of a rebuilding effort. And during this time, who is ready to just waltz back in to take what's his when the land has been thoroughly crushed? Ganondorf. It was all part of his plan, and that he was the source of everything. All he needs now is for two curious kids to find his body and remove the seal. And that's Breath of the Wild 2 for you guys. What did you think about this thought process? Do you think that Ganondorf is truly that big-brained in order to accomplish all of this? Because I think he is. We've seen it time and time again beforehand. Now this is just his grandest plan ever, because he is learning from his mistakes. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Leave your thoughts and theories there. And don't forget to share the video to keep the conversation going. Be sure to like and subscribe as I post Zelda content every week. And big thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping making this video happen. If you want to find out how you can support HMK for just $1 a month, please check out my Patreon page. Alright guys, until the next Zelda video, this has been HMK. And remember, it's all part of the plan. I'll check you guys later.